showtime.
Everyone to Pete Norman Court here in the Larry Call Gymnasium on the campus of Highland Community College in Freeport, Illinois. This is your great HMC broadcast here. I am the marvelous one, marvelous Mark Masters, along with Assault and the Sound, Jim Yeager. And we're going to put on one of the best streams you've ever seen. And that's the truth. Assault and the Sound runs a whole bunch of cameras here, and it's one of the best streams you're ever going to see. Now, the greatest streams you've ever heard, that's another story, but we ain't worried about that. I'm not a professional. I don't pretend to be one, and I certainly don't play one on TV. And tonight's matchup, or this afternoon, depending on how well you believe the sun going down early, is between your Highland Community College Cougars and the Kankakee Cavaliers. The Kankakee Cavaliers come into this game at 5-1. They are also a Region 4 foe. This is the Cougars' third Region 4 foe in a row. They took on Truman on Tuesday night and got the victory, and then a rare huge upset by Chicago Daily against the Cougars on Thursday. From the sounds of things, if the Cougars could ever play the worst game of their careers, they all did at one time, and Daily lit up the scoreboard. So for the first time ever, the Cougars lost to Daily in my 11 years, and they're looking to bounce back here against another Region 4 opponent. Again, the Region 4 is the tournament at the end of the season to see who gets the automatic bid. Well, not necessarily an automatic bid, a chance to get an automatic bid into the National Championship Tournament in Hutchinson, Kansas every year. Last season, the Cougars took on the Cavaliers in the semifinals of the Region 4. They struggled early on against them, but managed to pull out the victory late in the game, and then went on to have a huge upset against the number one seed Trojans from Triton. Triton back on their winning ways, 6-0 this season to start it off. And we won't see them for a few more. It might be in the middle of January when the Trojans come to town. But nonetheless here, Cougars come into the matchup 3-1. Again, the 11-point defeat to Daly on Thursday. Looking to bounce back. Look at some of the team. We have some people missing today. Ramin Hinton is a healthy scratch for coach's reasons. He is not in uniform today, as well as Matt Somerville, the 6'7 freshman from Chicago. He, I believe, has an injured hand. Those two are going to be some big misses, because Hinton comes into the game averaging a double-double, 12 points, 12 boards. Somerville averaging 13 for the Cougars. But the rest of the gang appears to be here. I believe Jaheim Siago is still in street clothes. He's in a walking boot, I believe. But we'll get going here in about 2 minutes to get on the show here. The next matchup will be this upcoming Tuesday, the 21st. The ladies will take on Milwaukee Tech here at 5 o'clock. The men will travel into Moberly for the Moberly Classic. That'll be next weekend. They always face the high-powered Moberly Greyhounds and State Fair Roadrunners, I believe. And that's an important tournament they have every year. At least the Cougars attend every year. And why not? Because if the Cougars win the Region 4, they will play the winner of that region, which is usually the Greyhounds over the last few years. But just in case, you play another couple teams.
Excuse me from that region.
But for the last, I don't know how many seasons in a row, the Moberly Greyhounds have come out of that region and usually have punched their ticket to the tournament like they did last year. They took out the Cougars. Cougars had an upset bid rolling, but the number four team in the nation at the time last season, the Greyhounds prevailed and went on to Hutchinson, Kansas. We're just under a minute to go here. We're about ready to roll. Again, good heavyweight matchup here between two Region 4 foes. Cougars 1-1 in the Region 4. Beat Truman on Tuesday, lost to Daly, surprisingly, on Thursday. Trying to get back on the winning ways here, their first loss of the season. And we'll see who steps up tonight. For the first time that I remember this season, Tyler Johnson will be in the starting lineup. As well as Troy Cole Jr. Now, I'm not sure if we're going to do the national anthem or not. I think so. And it will be. So sit back, relax, and enjoy. We'll be back in a second. We'll be rolling here in a second. Starting lineup's coming. Again, Highland comes into the matchup 3-1. Cavaliers 5-1. This will be a good test for Highland here as they face a really good team. The only loss for the Cavaliers comes against the high-powered and very reputable Vincennes Ball Club from Indiana. They make many a trips to the national tournament in Hutchinson, Kansas. So we shall see how the Cougars do here. Anyways, Craig, let's go.
Buckle up, weirdos. This one's going to be a good one.
And now, the starting lineup for your Highland Cougars. At one guard, a 6'3 sophomore from Bilbao, Spain. Number 3, Bosco, Buster Achia. And another guard, a 6-foot sophomore from St. Paul, Minnesota. Number 4, Demetrius Johnson. And a third guard, a 6'6 sophomore from Romeoville. Number 5, Tyler Johnson. At 1-4, a 6'4 sophomore from Baton Rouge, Louisiana. Number 11, Troy Cole Jr. And at the other 4, a 6'8 sophomore from Toronto, Canada. Number 23, Cyrus Noel. The Cougars are coached in his fourth season by Mr. Luke Norman.
Regulators, mount up. We're coming.
We're set to roll here. The Cougars will be moving right to left on your TV screens. They'll come out in their home white jerseys with orange numbers and letters trimmed in blue. Cavaliers will come out in their road blue jerseys with red letters and numbers trimmed in white. Cougars looking to bounce back from an upset defeat to Chicago Navy. They got a good test here today. We'll see how they answer the bell. Canada, Cyrus Noel set the jump center. And the tip will be controlled by the Cougars. Buster Achia picks it up, and he'll give it up top to D2, Demetrius Johnson the second. Buster Achia on the right side looking for a screen. Up top, Tyler Johnson. Cyrus Noel now over Cole Jr. Left side, Buster Achia to the rack. Up off the glass, no good. And stolen by Air Canada down low. No call. Cougars get a fresh 23 ball on the way. D2 around and out. Kankakee getting 5-1 on the season. Over to the left side. Looking inside now, 24. That's Smith, one of the three Smiths. Three ball on the way, way off. Rebounded by Buster Achia. Gonzalo pushes up to that's Tyler Johnson on the left side. The shot clock right in my way as usual. Now up top, Tyler Johnson. Left side, Cole Jr. D2 looking to drive. He'll go to the rack. Up on the left hand, swatted away. Burton with a block for the Cavaliers. Still knotted at zero here early on in the first half. Woods looking to drive on Buster Achia. Has a lane. Loses the ball out of bounds, and it will stay. He'll go back to the Cougars. 18:36 left to go first half. Still knotted at zero. Little full court token pressure by the Cavaliers. D2. After the clear out, will bring it up himself. Man-to-man defense are the Cavaliers. Gonzalo going to drive now over to the left side. D2 at the top of the key. Has an opening if he wants to take the drive. Has a mismatch against the 6-7. D2 for three. Got it! Demetrius Johnson for three, and the Cougars are on the board. Driving to the hole is Mason. Got quite the mismatch. He's banging down there. No good. Rebounded by Cole Jr. 3-0 Cougars with the early lead. Over to the left side now. D2 just hit a three. Let's see if he goes for another. Nice pass out. Cole Jr. back to D2. 15 left on the shot clock. Tyler Johnson going to pick up a nothing. He's going to take a traveling call, and Cougars will turn it over. The officials let them play here. You're going to see a lot of contact and not a lot of calls. Burton will bring it up now for the Cavaliers. Worked on by D2. Nice inside pass to Woods. For R. Smith for the bucket. Cougars still with the lead, and they're going to call a foul on number 12, Woods. His first. D2 brings the ball up now for Highland, leading 3-2. Inside for Cyrus. Air Canada going to face up, and he'll kick it out. Back down low to him again. Shot clock under 10. Cyrus trying to bang down low, and he lost the ball out of bounds. Burton, bring up the ball now. Dribbling to the hole. Up with a finger roll, and he got it. Four-two lead. Foster Achia kicks it out. Three ball on the way. Tyler Johnson got it. Cougars back in front now. 6-4, 16-25 left to go in the first half. Woods trying to get it inside. He did. Now inside pass to Mason. And they're going to call a jump ball, and the ball will stay with the Cavaliers. Six-four Highland here, 16-17 left to go, first half. Rashad Smith will take the ball out right underneath me here in the Jim Yeager balcony. Looking up top, easily stolen by D2. He's got a one-on-one matchup, and the ball knocked out of bounds. Jamonte Smith will, I believe, knock the ball out. Oh, excuse me, that was McKinney. Foster Achia will take the ball out as the Cougars are stacked. Looking up top, D2. 16-10 left to go, first half. Cougars by two. 6-4 on 2 3-pointers. Foster Achia looking to drive himself. No, now he'll go over D2. D2 can drive the hole. He does. Nice pass and a score. Air Canada, Cyrus Winnowell. He was the recipient of that beautiful assist by D2. And the Cougars up now, back again. Now 4. 8-4. Nice pass. They're getting open way too easily in there as Ray will corral that pass and score the bucket. Now a steal, no. Cougars pushing the ball up now. Foster Achia will go to the left hand. Easy layup for Il Bosco. Back to a 4-point lead for the Cougars. 10-6, 15-24. As I say, they're going to call a travel there. Say, if you're not going to call the foul, you got to call the travel. They call travel. The Cougars will get the ball back, leading by 4. Checking in for the Cougars, number 2, Marquand Adams. And Cole Jr. will have a seat. Marquand going to run the point here for the Cougars. Off now to D2. He's going to the rack. And not sure what they're calling. Call, it'll be on Nash, his first foul. D2 going to go to the line. This isn't Marquand Adams at the line. First free throw, round and out. Now, the Cougars have played 4 games, but somehow for the stats that I get, the only stats that I get off the internet, only have 2 games in it, so a lot of the Cougar stats are a little inflated at the moment. Second free throw up and in for D2. Now a 5-point lead for the Cougars, 11-6. Again, a good test here. The 5-1 Cavaliers, who they'll definitely see at least one more time, maybe 2, when the Region 4 tournament is held here, I believe. Nice help by the Cougars. Tough shot underneath, but no good, but an offensive board and a good foul by Tyler Johnson. Burton grabbed the offensive board from a shot that had no prayer. Tyler picks up the first foul for the Cougars. 14:52 left to go, first half. 5-point lead for your Cougars here. It's 11-6 Highland. Burton will go to the line for 2. First free throw, up and in. Second free throw by Burton, up and in. Full court pressure now, man to man. So everyone's just got to clear out of the way, and that's what they do, and Marquand can take control. easily breaking the man pressure. He goes right around his man. He's got a shot. Nice kick out. D2 going to take it to the hole. Got fouled, and he'll pick it up. Not sure if they're going to call that, but D2 will go back to the line for two more free throws. Monem Obut set to check in for Marquand Adams. I don't know if Marquand took a shot to the head. He doesn't look like he's feeling good. First free throw up and in for D2. One more free throw. Up and in. D2 gets them both, and the Cougars back up ahead by five. 13-8, 14-38 left to go first half. All the way, tough shot, but McKenzie scores the bucket. Cuts the lead to three by the Cougars. Bastrachia pushes it up to the left side, back to Gonzalo. Villabosco going to drive. No call on that play, and here comes Burton. And a nice steal. Oh, good hustle by D2 to get in between that passing lane. Tough play to get there. He got there, knocked the ball out of bounds, at least stopped the fast break. Great hustle by D2. Gonzalo took one off the kneecap, I think. He's hobbling. He will be substituted for. Cole Jr. set to come in for him, as well as Omar Njaya. Njai? Okay, thank you. Better. I'll get it before the end of the year. Nash will take the ball out for the Cavaliers. Turnaround jumper, no good. Nice rebound by Njai. He's wide open, but they can't find him. Over to Tyler Johnson on the right side. On the left side, that's Cole Jr. up top, D2. Inside and Jai. Back to D2. They're going to call. Yes, and Jai will pick up the foul. First foul for Njai. Nash going to look for a screen all the way over. McKenney. Muscling. It's a nice block by Abu. That should be a jump ball, and it is. Abu with a nice jump ball, and the Cougars get the ball. More full court man pressure coming by the Cavaliers. Tyler Johnson will take the ball out. Looks to get it to D2, and he does. .13-47. 3-point lead for your Cougars, 13-10. And Jai wants the ball. Can't get it to him. They get it to Tyler Johnson, who goes in. And they're going to say it's knocked out of bounds by a Cavalier. Okay, now that they've reversed that, and it'll go to the Cavaliers. It's going to say when all the Cougars are heading back the other direction, they obviously didn't believe they got the ball. Nash going to look for a double screen. He'll pull up for three. Got it. It looked like a three. They're only giving him two. Still a one-point lead for the Cougars. E2 up top, Tyler Johnson. Cole looking for a drive. Now back over Abud. Left side, D2. Going to take it himself. Kicks it out. Cole Jr. for three, got it. Troy Cole Jr. for three, and a timeout taken by Highland with 12:55 left to go in this first half. They lead 16-12. Stick with us, everyone. Your HMC broadcast will be right back. We're back here. Your Cougars up by four. 12:55 left to go in the half. Getting a good early, even though it's early, it's a good test in the region four. The Cougars upset by Daly. Cougars now in a rare zone defense. Now we'll see if the Cavaliers can shoot from the outside. Nice inside play there. De Silva, nice play. Tough shot, and it went in. Point lead for the Cougars. Cole Jr. here on the right side. Nice pump fake over Tyler Johnson. Looking inside, Njai. Kick it back out top. D2 looking in the corner. Abood for three. No good. Nice offensive board. Had an offensive board by Tyler Johnson, and he went out of bounds. Cougars could use some offensive boards. They were out-rebounded a lot in the first couple of games I've seen. But luckily for them, they managed to outscore the other ball club, which is always nice. Inside, Mason hands the ball off, and I think another foul on Tyler Johnson. Too easy for the layup. Tyler Johnson picks up foul number two. Ray will go to the line for two. Cougars lead by two. First shot by Ray, I was going to say, looks like it's going to hit some rim. Couldn't come back in. Air Canada Cyrus Noel will check back in as Tyler has a seat. Two fouls. We're just 8 minutes into this ballgame. Second free throw. Thought it was going to hit the back iron, but it goes in for Ray. 3 points for Ray. Lead down to one for the Cougars. They've led the whole way, or excuse me, they've led 6-4. It was 4-3, and then the Cougars hit their second three-pointer, and they've led since. Looking inside, and Jack can't get the ball. Cyrus going to take it himself. Nice spin out. Abood for three. Got it. Monem Abood for three. It gives it the Cougars back a four-point lead. One of the eight returnees on this ball club. He's a three-point sharpshooter, and he made him pay there. Defensive board by D2. And Cyrus is going to bring it up, puts it on the left side. Abood for another. Got it. Monem Abood for three. And the Cougars now up by the largest lead of the game, 7 points, and a timeout taken by the Cavaliers. 11:08 left to go in the half. The Cougars lead 22-15. Want to watch some more of this? The only place you can watch your Highland Cougars is streaming live worldwide right here on HMC. Welcome back. Monem Abood, the three-point sharpshooter, has lit it up from outside for two straight threes, and the Cougars now lead by seven. 11 minutes left to go in the half. Cougars again in their 2-3 zone. Forced inside. De Silva now kicks it out. Nice pump fake. Now up top, Nash. All the way over. Stolen by Cole Jr. Look at it as he throws down some thunder. Troy Cole Jr. lights the place up here with the steal and the dunk. A 9-point lead now for the Cougars. A left-handed hammer by Troy Cole Jr. And this crowd comes to life. Again, the Cougars led 3-0. And now another steal. This goes up to D2. He's got a one-on-one matchup. Draws the contact. It's blown out of bounds, and they tee him up. Just like that, Da Silva picks up a tee. I don't know if they were calling the foul as well. They should have, but like I've said. For flopping? I thought it was taunting. Either way, it doesn't matter. Tee comes up. Obud will pick up the free throws here. That still counts as a personal foul. And I don't think they called the personal foul at all. Free throw up and in for Abood. One more to go. 10-point lead now for the Cougars. This could be a turning point. Might be where the Cavaliers fall apart. Abood misses the second one. Abood, two straight three-pointers, took a 1-point lead to a 7-point lead. Now the Cougars got the ball out under their own basket. Up by 10. Largest lead of the game for either team. Nice pass inside. Oh, Cyrus couldn't corral it and goes through his hands out of bounds. Cyrus Noel, I think, was looking for the dunk himself as he had a wide open lane. Unfortunately, lost the handle, and the Cavaliers will take control here, trailing by 10. 10-10 to go in the first half. Highland's offense has been alive, but a lot of good looks by the Cavaliers, and there's one more. No good. Another rebound by D2. Under 10 minutes to go here in the half, and the Cougars starting to get sloppy. Lost that ball out of bounds. Another unforced error on the Cougars. Nash will bring it up. 9:50 to go in the half. 25-15 Highland. Mason, jumper, got it. First bucket for Mason. D2 will bring the ball up for the Cougars. Cole Jr. going to try to the hole. Nice pass. And jive for two. Cougar lead back to 10, 27-17. Cougars appear to still be in the 2-3 zone. It has given the Cavaliers a little bit of fits here as a couple steals. Almost got one there on the lost ball over in the corner. Woods, pull-up jumper, tough shot. And Cyrus had it. Cougars call timeout as, in remembrance of the ball on the helmet in the Super Bowl by the Giants, Cyrus had it pinned to his hip, called timeout. The Cougars will maintain possession. So with 8:55 left to go in the first half, your Cougars have extended out their lead. It's 10 points, 27-17. Stick with us, everyone. This is your HMC broadcast. Welcome back, everyone. Cougars coming out of the timeout after the miss by the Cavaliers. Air Canada, Cyrus Noel came down with the rebound and kind of lost it. Pinned it to his hip and called, wisely called timeout quickly. Now the 2-3 zone is going back to the Cavaliers. Nice job. Good pass inside. And a foul called. Cyrus Noel went up for the shot. And he got fouled from behind. I believe that will be on number 11, Burton. It is. Burton's first. And going to the line for two is Cyrus Noel. First free throw up and in for Air Canada. Cyrus averaging 6 points, 5 boards a game here. One more free throw coming. Cougars out to their biggest lead, 11, now 12 points. Nash will bring the ball up. If I'm a Cavalier, I'm not rushing yet. Had lots of good looks. Just haven't cashed in on them yet. Nash going to drive to the hole. Lost the ball. It still lost it. How many times does he get to lose it? And they're going to call jump ball. It will stay with the Cavaliers, though. 8:25 left to go in the half. 12-point lead for your Cougars, 29-17. Nash will take the ball out right underneath me here in the Jim Yeager balcony. Now looking. He will get it. I believe that's Woods. No, that's Ray. I'll get him right eventually. Now Woods has the ball. Up top to Nash. 1 second left on the shot clock, and wow. Tough shot by Nash, but he knocks down the three with 1 second left to go. Cuts the lead down to 9. Abood to answer. No good. And ball's free. Look at Cyrus Noel get on the ball. And they're going to call, I believe, a loose ball foul. Maybe? Yes. Parachica will pick up his first foul. Tyler Johnson set to check back in. Keep in mind, Tyler Johnson, 2 fouls. Abood will have a seat. Abood has sparked this offense here, only leading it by 1 at the time. He drained 2 consecutive threes to put it to 7. Right now it's sitting at 9, 29-20, just under 8 minutes to go in the half. Nash over to Mason. Now up top, Burton. Now we'll kick out. 3 ball on the way. Nice. There's got to be an over the back, and we got it on Mason. Mason picks up foul number 1. Great job blocking out by Tyler Johnson. Cougars have the ball in a 9-point lead. 7:42 left to go in the half. D2 will bring the ball up for the Cougars. And the Cougars upset by Daly, Chicago Daly, a team they hadn't lost to in my 11 years here. Everything fell apart and everything came together for the Daly Bulldogs, and the Cougars fall already in the season. Pass by D2, tried to get it inside Parachica, and it's intercepted. Just over 7 minutes to go in the half, and the Cougars still lead by 9. Nash looking to set it up. Cougars back in man-to-man defense. Burton, tough shot, no good. And he's out of bounds when he gets the rebound. Cougars must have listened to me. They're doing a great job boxing out now. Not a lot of second chance opportunities for the Cavaliers. Full court pressure now for the Cavaliers. Still man-to-man. Troy Cole will give it to D2, and he'll bring it across the line. Appears to be still 2-3 zone. 3 ball on the way. Cole Jr. can't get it. Parachica trying to get the rebound. Can't come up with it. Still a 9-point lead. 6:42 left to go in the half. Up top, Burton in the corner. Mason for 3. Not even close. Tyler Johnson with the board. Coach wants him to push. Tyler Johnson with the ball on the left side. Now up top, Air Canada. Parachica inside. Ball knocked out. I believe that's Cole Jr. It is. Parachica open for a split second. Couldn't find him. Now was there, but unfortunately, they threw it out of bounds. Right idea by Tyler Johnson. Parachica just not ready for it, and it sailed on him. 6:16 left to go in the half. Still 29-20. Cavaliers bring the ball up. Nash almost got away with one. Burton on the right side, worked on by Air Canada. Pump fake, he's going to go to the lane. He'll be met by another Cougar. Kicks it out to Woods. He loses the ball. Tyler Johnson will give it to D2, and the Cougars look to push to the left side. Cole Jr. back up, D2, looking to reset it up. Parachica looking inside. Air Canada gets it. Nice pump fake. He'll get it to Cole Jr. up off the glass and in. Troy Cole Jr. now 7 points for him. And back to an 11-point lead for the Cougars. 5:28 left to go first half. Highlands played a magnificent first half. Off to the left side. 3 ball on the way. Got it. Smith for 3. D2 inside. Parachica. Nice play, up and in. Boris Parachica will get the bucket. And the lead back to 10 for the Cougars. 33-23, 5 minutes to go. Inside, Mason ticks it off the cranium. He's going to go baseline ball, knocked out of bounds by Tyler Johnson. El Bosco Bastarachia has some ice on the ankle over there, most likely doubtful for the rest of this game. Not a good sign for the Cougars. Omar and Jai has checked back in. Parachita has a seat. Silva with the ball. Now he lost his dribble. Nice job by the Cougar defense. Kicks the ball out. Burton going to drive. Took a few too many steps, but he missed it anyways. Rebounded by Johnson. D2 will get it up. Nice side. And Jai for the jam. Omar and Jai for the hammer. And the Cougar bench comes alive. Timeout taken by the Cavaliers. 4:33 left to go in this first half. Your Highland Cougars back out to their biggest lead of the game. 12 as they lead 35-23. Want to finish watching some more slams? Stick with us here at HMC. Welcome back, everyone. Hopefully getting a chance to be entertained by the new instant replay here by HMC. A couple of thunderous dunks here. Troy Cole Jr. with a left-handed hammer, and also Omar and Jai with a two-handed crush. And the Cougars lead by 12, 35-23, with 4:30 left to go in the half. McKinney on the drive, and they're going to call a travel. I've told you, the officials let them play in this building. Doesn't necessarily benefit the Cougars a lot, but now some full court man pressure and back to D2. Everybody get out of the way. D2 hands back, gives it to Cyrus. Now I'll hand it back to him. Up top, Tyler Johnson, shot clock at 15. Cole Jr. is going to get called for the offensive foul. That'll be his first. .404 left to go in the first half. 35-23 Highland. They've trailed only once, and that was at 4-3 early on. The Cougars hit another three and made it 6-4. They've been leading ever since. The 5-1 Kankakee Cavaliers. De Silva, jumper, got it. 3:45 to go here in the half. D2 looking for the drive. And a steal by McKinney. They're going to call a jump ball, and it will stay with the Cavaliers. D2 maybe a little sloppy with the dribble. McKinney got the steal, got the jump ball. Oh, the jump ball will go to Highland. I thought it was pointing to the Cavaliers unless somebody forgot to switch it. Nonetheless, Cougars will maintain possession here. 3:36 left to go in the first half. They lead by 10, 35-25. Here's back to be man-to-man defense for the Cavaliers. Looking for a screen. I believe they're going to call one on McKinney. Or they're going to call a moving screen on an Njai, I believe. We haven't officially put it up there that I know of. And now we have. It is his second. Appears to be an official. Once again, we're struggling with the shot clocks. Either way, not sure how much time they got left to go. And here we go. McKinney, Cougars back in their 2-3 zone. Burton looking back up top to McKinney. Three ball on the way by Burton. Got it. Chip, chip, chipping away. The Cougars led by 12. They now lead by 7. Tyler Johnson will set up for a wide open three. Got it. T.Y. Tyler Johnson. Cougar lead back to 10 just under 3 minutes to go in the half. Cougars zone doing well. Almost stolen by D2. Ball out of bounds. Should go to the Cougars. It does. Nice defense. D2 forcing the ball out of his hands, off his foot, and out of bounds. Marquan Adams has checked in. Omar Najai will have a seat. Cougars got D2, Abood, Marquan Adams, Air Canada, and Tyler Johnson in. Appears to be man defense and a ball knocked away by the Cavaliers. Da Silva does dish it off to Burton and he'll get the bucket. Cougars want to push the ball. I don't know if there's an inadvertent whistle or what, but just over 2 minutes to go. D2 left wide open for three. No good. Burton will try to start the break by himself. Tough shot, and he got fouled. Just under 2 minutes to go. The Cougar lead is 8 at 38-30. Burton will go to the line for two. Abood picks up the foul, his first. Burton going to the line for two. First free throw up off the back iron. One more free throw coming. Cougars lead is 8. 1:59 to go in the half. Up and in for Burton. Full court pressure. D2 up top. We'll get the ball off the screen. Has the open three if he wants it, but Abood will take it. Had a wide open one, unfortunately missed it. Cougars on fire threes. Not there anymore. Da Silva, tough shot. Went to the hole and got it. Lead down now to 5. 1:30 to go in the half. Cougars led by as many as 12. And picking up another foul on McKinney. I believe that's his second. And now Marquan Adams going to the line for one and a bonus. Nope, only the first for McKinney. But Marquan Adams will go to the line for one and the bonus. .124 to go in the half, 38-33 Cougars. Marquan looking to add to it right here. He'll set, shoot, around and out. Silva to bring the ball up for the Cavaliers. Over to McKinney. They could cut it down to 2 if they want. Mason, run around, no good. Tipped here, tipped there, tipped everywhere. Now who's it going to be to? Cougars will get possession. 1:08 to go in this first half. The Cougars with the ball, leading by 5, 38-33. Marquan. Pick up the ball, and he's going to push it. Add a lane, he'll back it back out. Up top, Cole Jr., he's going to drive to the hole. Up with the left hand, up off the glass, no good. And tipped out of bounds, and it will go to the Cavaliers. Under a minute to go, 49 seconds here in the first half. Cougars with a 5-point lead. They lead 38-33. Cavaliers with the ball. Kenny will bring the ball up for the Cavaliers. It's about a 20-second difference, just under a 20-second difference to the shot clock. McKinney to the hole. Tough shot, not even close. Cole Jr. will get the ball on the He'll go up with the left hand. No good. Pretty much a shot clock and game clock are deadlocked here with 23 seconds to go. If anything, it's a half-second difference. And DeSilva's going to pull the ball back and try and get one last shot. Down to 13. We're at 10. Down to 7. Here comes the screen. Kicks it out. Mason's going to have a tough shot with 4. Looks short. It is. Burton, runner if it goes, no good. And that's the end of the first half. Cougars led by as many as 12 during this first half, but they come away with a 5-point lead at the break. They lead 38-33. Scoring El Bosco on the bench with a bum ankle. Looks like he's got some ice on it. He's got 2. 6 points for D2, 6 points for Tyler Johnson, 7 points for Monem Obud, 7 points for Troy Cole Jr., 2 for Parachitza, 4 for Najai, and Cyrus Noel with 4. That gives your Cougars 38 points here. Another tough standard here to go up against a Region 4 opponent, a team they're going to see more than once, and they're going to see him right now, and they got the lead. So the Cougars, good first half here. Let's see if they can keep it up in the second. We'll be back in under 14 minutes for the second half. Stick with us, everyone. Welcome back, everyone. A few more stats here. Cougars shooting 52% for the field goals from the first half and 50% from behind the three-point arc, 6 of 12. Kankakee shooting 43%, which is still really good in the first half, field goal-wise, but 3 of 9, 33% from beyond the three-point arc. Cougars got 12 assists and 13 turnovers. Hopefully we can change the turnovers a little bit, but 5 assists by D2. 4 blocks and 7 steals for the Cougars. Getting the largest lead of the game. There's only been 2 lead changes. The largest lead is 12 points. The Cougars led 29-17. So points off of turnovers, the Cougars got 10, the Cavaliers with 16. Points in the paint, both of them have 14. Three-point efficiency, plus 14.1 for the Cougars and only plus 1.6 for the Cavaliers. Bench points are even at 13 apiece. So, yeah, if you're a Cougar fan, you're happy with the lead, but had a bigger lead at one point, and the Cavaliers have gotten plenty of good looks, just haven't knocked them down yet. So we're about 7.5 left to go here before we start the second half, so stick with us, everyone. This is your HMC broadcast. We stream every home game from the ladies to the men all the time. So every game you want to see, don't forget to check us out. Again, next home game should be Tuesday, November 21st. The ladies will take on Milwaukee Tech. So that'll be our next home broadcast. So we'll be back in a little over 7 minutes for the second half. Stay with us, everyone. Welcome back, everyone. It's your HMC broadcast here for your Highland Cougars. The only place we stream is live worldwide, and the only place you can see your Highland Cougar sports, basketball, and other sports is right here on HMC. Cougars led by as many as 12 in the first half. It is down to 5. Cavaliers should control here to start the second half. The Cougars now be moving left to right on your TV screens. And Buster Achia has lost the bag of ice, but unfortunately not gained his basketball shoes. He's in the flip-flops, slip-ons, whatever you want to call them. So he appears to be out for the rest of the game. Starters minus Buster Achia are in. In place of Buster Achia's Marquand Adams. Again, Cougars had a solid first half, although the Cavaliers had many good looks. Didn't knock them all down, so hopefully the Cougars' defense can still be there and shut down this Cavaliers' offense. Cavaliers 5-1 on the season. Cougars 3-1. Up top, Mason looking for a cutter. Now he'll get it to the left side. De Silva for 3, got it. Or no, excuse me, that was Woods. Saw the 2. Cougar lead now cut to 2. D2 going to take it to the hole. Up with the left hand, swatted away, but rebounded by Cyrus Noel. Had the offensive board, couldn't convert. Cavaliers' last lead was 4-3 early on in the ballgame. They trailed by 2, looking for a tie or the lead. Nice inside pass again. Those were there all day. Ray with a bucket, and now we're tied at 38. Marquand Adams. And the drive to the left. We'll kick it up top. D2. Cole Jr. Now gives it to Cyrus. D2 will take it with 10 left on the shot clock. Cole for 3. Got it. Troy Cole Jr. for 3, and that's 10 points for him. Oh, Marquand Adams knocks the ball out of bounds. Cougar defense is there. Abood will check in for Cole Jr. Cougar lead 41-38 here, 18-28 left to go in the ballgame. Full court man pressure now by the Cougars. No, and now it appears to be, I don't know, it doesn't matter what it was. Burton. How many steps does he get? And they finally said not that many. Turnover by the Cavaliers. And now some full court pressure. Again, it's mostly been man. When that happens, just clear out. Usually take their man with you. Marquand's going to go right around him anyways. He'll go all the way to the rack and lost the ball on the way up. I don't think he was trying to alley-oop it off the backboard, but he lost the ball on the way up. 3 ball on the way. And it's good for Woods. Second 3 ball for Woods, and we're tied back at 41. Cavaliers were chipping away, and they got back and tied it up after being down by as many as 12 in the first half. Inside, Cyrus Noel, a host of Cavaliers all over him. They're going to call, I believe, a jump ball. Marquand Adams set to check in the ball here, or unless the ball went out of bounds somehow. Cyrus going to bring it up himself. Take it up with the left hand and 1! Cyrus Noel, Air Canada Skies, got the foul called and put it down. Mason picks up the foul, his second, going to the line. Air Canada looking to add the 3-point play. Go, 17-27. to go in the ball game. Cougars' lead is up to two. Chance to go to three here on the and one free throw by Cyrus Noel. Lefty lets it fly. No good. Tipped around. Cavaliers will control here. All the way down, blocked, but unfortunately right there was Burton. He dunks it home and he gets fouled. So a chance for the Cavaliers to get back in the lead. They haven't led since 4-3. D2 picks up the foul, his first. And the Boo Birds from the baseball team are here. And he missed it. T.Y. Tyler Johnson pulls down the board. D2 going to go through the defense. Still tied at 43. Marquan Adams, booed, now D2. Marquan looking to drive. Lost the ball out of bounds and will stay with the Cougars. Marquan will take the ball out underneath me here. Looking, we'll get it to D2, out top of the Abood. Shot clock down to 5. Cyrus going to go all the way to the rec. Up with the left hand, no good. Got the offensive board. And no call. Marquan will pick up the foul. Marquan's first. 16:42 to go in the ball game, tied at 43. And Cougars led by as many as 12 in the first half. Cavaliers chipped away, got it down to 5 at the break, and have their first chance at a lead in a long time. Three ball on the way, no good, and an over the back on Burton. Nice job boxing out once again by D2. It should be Burton's second. Still tied at 43, 16:30 left to go. Region 4 matchup here. This is going to go in the books and help the seeding for the Region 4 tournament. Abood will get it to Tyler Johnson. Marquan for 3, off the glass, no good, offensive board. Ah. Cyrus had it, got it taken away. Burton lost the handle, and here come the Cougars. D2. We'll back it up. Had a chance for some transition points. All the way in the corner. Tyler now up top. Inside, Marquan, nice pump fake. Another nice pump fake, 3 of him, and he still missed the easy bunny. But an offensive board, number 5, Air Canada, still not getting it. Got another offensive board. Nothing's getting called here, but they'll call that. Wow. We had 5 guys lose an arm. But the hip check gets the call. That's on Mason. Mason picks up foul number 3. First and 10 should have been the call. And the Cougars throw it away. Still stuck on 43s here. 15:39 left to go. And Nash will bring up the ball. Cougars still in man defense. Mason will hand off. Now Woods all the way. And they're going to call that. Cyrus will pick up the foul. We had 3 guys lose an arm down here. It's not that it might have been a foul. Might not have been a foul, but we had 5 falls down here, and none of them were called. That's what just irritates me. Boo Birds back in business here. From the baseball team, Woods' free throw up and in. Marquan Adams has a seat, along with Air Canada Cyrus Noel. As Njai checks in, along with Cole Jr., one more free throw. It was 4-3, 40 points ago. Now a 2-point lead, the biggest of the game for the Cavaliers. D2 now over Cole Jr. Tyler Johnson up top, Abood. Inside, and Jai. Ball knocked away, and Jai will control. 3 seconds on the shot clock. Nice pass inside, and Jai. That should be goaltending, and they will count it. And Jai will pick up the bucket. And the lead, and it's tied back at 45. 14:51 left to go in the ball game. He may not have touched the ball, but he hindered the backboard, caused the rim to move, and that will be offensive goaltending, and the ball will go out of bounds. It's great putting your hands up, but grab the ball as it was starting to go out of bounds. Cougars could have went the other direction. It will stay with the Cavaliers. 14:41 to go in the ball game. Knotted at 45. Kick by Cole Jr. out of bounds. We'll do it again. Nash up top, McKinney. Woods for another three, looks short. And right there, Cole Jr. hauls down a board. Picks up his dribble, only in the corner, D2. Looking for Njai, all the way to the rack. Tough shot, and it's in. D2, great basket. Puts the Cougars back in front. D2. 47-45 Cougars. Nash inside to Mason. Mason with three fouls. He'll pull up instead. Another board by D2, his fourth. The Cougars with a two-point lead. 14 minutes to go in the ballgame. D2 now over to Abood. Back to D2. He's going to dribble to the left, maybe draw a double team. Now he's got a one-on-one matchup with Burton. Kicks it all the way out. Abood for three, got it! Abood for another three, his third of the ball game. Timeout taken, I believe, by Highland. 13:42 left to go in the ball game. Cougars got back up by five. They lead 50-45. Want to watch the end of the Region 4 matchup? You can only watch it right here on HMC. Stick with us. Welcome back, everyone. Again, hope you're enjoying our new toy here, the toy of instant replay. And we love using it, and we're going to use it a lot more. Great job there by layups by D2. And, of course, the big three by Abood has pushed the Cougar lead out to five now. It's 50-45, 13:42 left to go in the ballgame. This is the Cougars' third Region 4 matchup in a row. Now they're back into the 2-3 zone. Cougars got the easy win over Truman, and then everything just fell apart against Daly, a team they hadn't lost to in my 11 years, and they dropped one by 11 on Thursday. Tough shot. And it appears it's going to be on D2, his second. One to the line for two is Nash. Bluebird's coming alive here again on the opposite side of your TV screen, upper left-hand corner, free throw up and in for Nash. Bluebirds are the members from the Dominican Republic of our baseball team. At least I think most of them are from the Dominican Republic. They show up and have great support here for the ball club. Second free throw, no good, out of bounds, and it'll go to the Cougars. So the lead cut to four, but Highland has possession. And now some full court pressure again, just man-to-man. Everyone clears out. D2 going to kick it up. Here comes Cole Jr. He tries to throw down, and he got fouled. If that's on Burton, that's his third. We shall see. It is not. It'll be on Nash. Nash picks up the foul, his third. I only had two, but I'll give him another one.
I'll allow it.
Shooting two now is Troy Cole Jr., the sophomore from Louisiana. 13-16 left to go. First free throw up and in. Eleven points now for Cole Jr. Cougars lead 51-46, 13-16 left to go. Second free throw up and in. Lead is six for Highland here. Just over 13 minutes to go in the ball game. Nash will bring it up against the 2-3 zone of the Cougars. Cougars don't play a lot of zone, but this might be just enough to change up the Cavaliers' offense, maybe get them out of the rhythm if they had one. So far, so good. Working a lot of clock as they work the ball around. I believe that was Da Silva for a three, no good. And should have been a foul called, but ball tipped right to McKinney, and he gets the bucket. Four-point lead now for Highland. Abood for another three. Look out. Missed that one. Abood lands on the floor. Nash will go up with the left hand and score. The lead now cut to two. It was six. D2 going to bring it up now for Highland. 12:22 left to go in the ballgame. Abood up top now. Old Junior looking inside, gets it. Njai banging down low. Ball knocked out of bounds. Should stay with the Cougars. Air Canada, Cyrus Noel checking in. Tyler Johnson will have a seat. 12 minutes, just over 12 minutes to go in this ball game. The Cougars with a two-point lead, but the ball here. And D2 will control the ball here. Should be up top. They get it to Troy. Troy Cole up with the left hand, got it! Troy Cole Jr. for another bucket. And the Cougars' lead is now four. Under 12 minutes to go in the ball game. In Region 4 matchup. Tough play for Da Silva, and he's going to pick up the foul against Air Canada most likely. Only his second, though. Parachita will check in most likely for Njai. I thought it was going to be for Noel. Picked up the foul, but it is not. I believe the Boo Birds are singing now. Getting something new every time. McKenzie, tough jumper, but he got it. Lead now cut to two. 11:40 left to go in the ballgame. 54-52 Highland. Going all the way. Tough play all the way out. Cole Jr. Parachita looking for the three. No good, but right there. Rebound number five by D2. Nice pass to Parachita for the bucket. Boris Parachita for an easy bucket. And a four-point lead again. Should be jump ball. They got it. McKinney not happy. Possession arrow will stick with the Cavaliers. Highland by four. 11:08 left to go in the ballgame. Mason set back to check in. Burton will have a seat. Woods going to take the ball out, and we'll kick it into Da Silva. Cougars still in their, as they're still in their zone. Parachita getting a little cheating out front. Needs to step back. Ball inside Da Silva. Tough play down low, knocked away and stolen by Abood. Four-point lead for the Cougars. Just under 11 minutes to go. D2 setting up the play here for the Cougars. He take it himself. He got tripped and they called it. Nice call by the officials. D2 goes down hard after the trip, but the foul will be called on 20. I don't know. Is there a 20 even out here? Maybe just the two. I guess they called it on number two, McKinney, his second. Marquand Adams checks in for D2. Cole Jr. will get the ball here. 10:30 to go in the ball game. The Cougars with the ball and a four-point lead. Marquand looking inside, gets it to Air Canada. He's going to go baseline. Power up strong, nice block there. The block by Ray, and he's going to lead the break, and the ball's going to go out of bounds. Unforced air for the Cavaliers. They could use that one back. The Boo Birds giving them a little cheer. 10:14 to go in the ball game. 56-52, Highland with the lead. Cavaliers come into this matchup 5-1, only loss to high-powered Vincennes, a Hutchinson, Kansas National Tournament regular. Oh, not a good pass by not a good pass by Marquand. Got tipped out of bounds. The Cougars will maintain possession, but way in the backcourt. Marquand going to bring it up as we reach the 10-minute mark here left in the ballgame. 56-52 Highland. Marquand going to go right around his man, up for the layup, and he got it. Marquand Adams for the bucket. The Cougar lead now to 6. Da Silva going to the hole, and they're going to call the charge. Only the second foul on Da Silva, but an offensive foul. Silva got the... got the technical early in the ball game. This is his second one, so doing a great job staying out of foul trouble. The big man for the Cavaliers. 9:34 to go in the ball game. The Cougars with a 6-point lead and the ball, 58-52. Marquand going to take the ball. He got fouled. That could be number 3 on Da Silva. Got to be getting close to the bonus, and we are. Marquand Adams from Victory Rock Prep in Florida, going to the line for a 1 in the bonus. .925 to go, 58-52 Highland. Marquand Adams set to the line for 1 and a bonus. That free throw up, missed off to the back iron. Still a 6-point lead for the Cougars. Cavaliers want to push it. Push the tempo a little bit. And they throw it away yet again. Marquand's going to rush down to the other end. Cougars got maybe a break. They get it to Cole Jr. He's hammered. No call. Or a very late call to the least. Going to call it on Ray. Only his first. But another 1 in the bonus coming up here. This one for Troy Cole Jr. 14 points for Troy Cole Jr. here. So far, great game for the sophomore. Free throw up and in. I guess the Cougars are in the double bonus now. Every foul from here on out, 9:09 to go, is going to be 2 free throws for the Cougars. Troy Cole hit the first one, got 1 more coming. 15 points for the sophomore. He'll set, shoot, and score. 2-3 zone for the Cougars as their lead now grows to 8. Led by as many as 12 in the first half, trailed by as many as 3 here in the second. Ash with the ball. Going to dribble. Nice dish off. Tough shot. No good. Burton had the offensive board. He got it again. Blocked by good old Air Canada. Mason inside. Now kicking out. Nash for three, looks off the left side, and a big rebound for Burton. Offensive board inside, Mason got the bucket. Only 4 points for Mason. Nobody looking to help the Cougars here. Timeout taken by Highland. 8:25 to go in the ball game. They have a 6-point lead. They lead 60-54. The only place you can watch the end of this Region 4 matchup is streaming live worldwide right here on HMC. Stick with us, everyone. Welcome back, everyone. Highland Cougars with a 6-point lead here. The inbounder forgot who they were and left Marquand Adams all the way at the other end of the court. Not sure if the five count starts at a certain moment, but to prevent a turnover, Coach Luke Norman took a timeout. That's what I was going to say. I didn't think they could substitute just coming out of a as D2 came to the scorer's table as everyone was in the game. So he's got to wait. Now he can check in at the next dead ball. Not a great place to pick up your dribble just across the half-court line, but luckily for us, now it's a 1-2-2 zone. We'll see how the Cougars do. Abood can hit the threes, hit several already. He's got three of them. Cyrus all the way over. Nice ball movement. There he is! Just off the front of the rim. Who wants the rebound? Cougars just don't get to it. Abood's hit 3 3-pointers already tonight. Under 8 minutes to go in the ball game. The Cougars by 6. Smith now over to Mason. Burton. Shot clock down to 6. Burton, not sure where he's going. Mason's going to have to take it, and he's going to call a travel, I believe. Cavaliers turn it over. Shot clock was down to 4. Mason had to make a play and took too many steps. 3:34 left to go, or excuse me, 7:34 left to go in the ballgame. 60-54 Highland. More full court pressure. It looks to be like a zone trap. Nice job by the Cougars to break it easily. 1-2-2 zone by the Cavaliers. See if the Cougars can get inside. They do to Cyrus. Cyrus to Parachica outside. D2 for 3. Got it! D2 for 3. And just like that, the Cougar lead up to 9. 7:07 left to go in the ballgame. Ball knocked out of bounds, and it's going to go to the Cougars? I believe so. I didn't see the official who called it. It appears to go to the Cougars if everybody's making their way back down to this side of the gym. Marquand set to take the ball out for the Cougars. Most likely going to get it to number 4, D2. And he does. Marquand will bring it up. Cougars bring a man to the middle. Now D2's down the other side. Marquand will easily bring it up. Wide open lane for Cyrus. And a great layup by Air Canada. Cyrus Noel has put the lead back up into double digits. It's 11 for the Cougars. 6:35 to go in the ballgame. 65-54 Highland. All the way. And a block by 2 players, unfortunately. Went right to Burton for the offensive board. And he'll score again. Lead is 9. Marquand Adams will bring the ball up. Still some full court pressure, but the Cougars have not really had a whole lot of problems with the pressure yet. D2 going to take it to the hole. Nice dish off. Paratizza will lay it in. And a timeout taken by Highland. 6:01 to go in the ball game. The Cougar lead back to 11, 67-56. Stick with us, everyone. This Region 4 matchup ain't over yet. The only place you can watch it is right here on HMC. Stick with us. Welcome back, everyone. 6:01 left to go in the ballgame. The Cougar lead is back to 11. They led by as many as 12 in the first half. Doing a great job getting that lead back to double digits. They lead 67-56. Ian, the Sultan of Sound, thought this would be a good test for the Cougars after the upset loss to Daly, and so far they've answered the call. Offense and defensively. Air Canada working on, I believe, Ray. Now Woods going all the way down, and he's going to get fouled. D2 will pick up the foul, I believe his third. Well, 5:40 left to go. Woods will go to the line for two. And around and out, the Boo Birds get some magic. Yeah, they're in the upper right-hand corner of your TV screen. Some of them. Second free throw by Woods, got it. Lead is 10. Just over 5.5 to go in the ball game. The Cougars with the ball. Mark Juan over to D2. Two up top, Tyler Johnson. Looking inside for Cyrus, they had him. Marquand gonna dribble inside. He'll kick it back out, shot clock under 10. Arachita gonna move out of the way. Pull up jumper, D2, got it! D2 with a big jumper. And the lead now to 12. Biggest lead of the ball game for the Cougars. Again, 12 points, 69-57, 5 minutes to go in the ball game. Ooh, coach wanted a travel. They're going to call a hold. And I believe that'll be on Marquand. Marquand Adams picks up his second foul. No one in real serious trouble. Only one person with three, and that's D2. And we got under 5 minutes to go in the ball game, so we'll see here. One in the bonus, up and in for Woods. Arachita got a little early there. Wanted to go back down and play some offense. He's got to come down for one more free throw. 4:53 to go in the ball game. 69-58 Cougars. Woods hits the next one. More full court pressure. The Cougars really haven't been threatened by any of this yet. Like I said, as Marquand can just dribble it up, him and D2, a couple of the best ball handlers on the ball club, and they do a good job handling the rock. Tyler Johnson on the left side. We'll get it. Marquand Adams. Three ball on the way. D2 just off the back iron. 4:30 to go in the ball game. Cougars lead by 10. Woods trying to answer. He does. And it is three. His third three-pointer of the ball game. 7-point lead now for the Cougars as we're closing in on 4 minutes to go of the ball game. Zone now for the Cavaliers. Leaving Tyler Johnson wide open. Looks short. It is, and a tip. Burton will tip it to his own man with 4 minutes to go in the ball game. The Cougar lead is 7. Woods going to take it himself. Pull-up jumper, got it. Woods wants to take control of the offensive scoring for the Cavaliers. And so far, he's got the lead down to 5. Was 12 not that long ago. Marquand Adams will cross the timeline here with 3:40 left to go in the ballgame. Cougars could need a bucket here. Tough shot, tipped, and the ball knocked away. And a layup at the other end. No one got back easily for Ray. The lead down to 3 with 3:20 to go in the ballgame. Cougars need to take their time and get a good shot here and a bucket. D2, going to lob it. Parachica. They're going to call a foul against D2 after the pass. They're going to call a block. Not sure who they called it on yet. They called it on Mason, his 4th. He's really the only one in foul trouble for the Cavaliers. But D2 going to the line for yet another pair. First free throw, up and in. I don't know why it's one in the bonus. Well, they said double bonus before, but I guess we're in one in the bonus. It doesn't matter. He made the first one, so he gets another one. Cougar lead to 4, 3:10 left to go. The St. Paul native knocks another one down. 5 of 6 from the line for D2. Cougars back in their 2-3 zone. 15 points for D2. Mason, no good. Tyler Johnson with the board. The Cougars 2:50 to go in the ballgame. 5-point lead. They don't need to rush it. Can eat some clock. Hopefully get a good shot. Marquand Adams on the right side. Now inside. Cyrus Noel. Tough shot up with the left hand. No good. But there's Cole Jr. for the board and the bucket. The Cougars didn't waste a lot of time, but they did get with the important thing, which was the bucket. The lead to 7 and about to shrink to 5. An easy play to Ray down low. Cougars let him get behind him. Timeout taken by Kankakee. 2:24 left to go in the ballgame. The Cougar lead is down to 5. They lead 73-68. This is your only way to watch your Highland Cougar sports is right here on HMC. Stick with us, everyone. We'll be back in a minute. Welcome back. 2:24 to go in the ball game. Cougars have led by as many as 12 in the first and second half here. Their lead is down to 5, I believe. Yes. More full court pressure by the Cavaliers. Cougars have not had any problems with a press break. They get it to Cole Jr., now to Johnson. Cougars should, and they do, they kick it back. Eat some clock here, just over 2 minutes. They run it down to 5 seconds left on the shot clock. It'll be under 2 minutes when the Cougars heave up a shot. Inside, Cyrus tried to pass it inside. Should be Cougar ball, and it is. Burton had the ball. He's kind of shocked that he lost it out of bounds, but the Cougars get the ball. Shot clock down to 12. 2:05 to go in the ball game. Marquand. Going to launch the 3. Got it! Marquand Adams with a huge 3 in the lead up to 8. Under 2 minutes to go. 76-68. All the way to the rack and in for Woods. Woods appears to be the offensive juggernaut here that they want. The Cougars get the ball over the time. 1:30 to go in the ball game. The lead is 6 for Highland. B2 be about a minute 15 if the Cougars run the clock down and heave one up. 1-2-2 zone. Still for Kankakee. Tyler Johnson, jumper, got it! Tyler Johnson, 8 points now for him and a huge bucket. 1:10 to go in the ballgame, an 8-point lead for the Cougars. Nash, tough shot up off the glass, no good. Offensive board, nice job, Cole Jr. for the steal. Burton with the offensive board, Cole Jr. just took it away from him. And under a minute to go, the Cougars by 8. D2 will control the ball. They're going to have to start fouling here sooner or later if they want. And there it is. Woods will pick up the foul. Only the second on Woods. Kind of shocked once they got it up here and a minute was left. They wasted 15 seconds or more. It's down to 42 seconds in the game. But shooting two is Marquand Adams. First free throw up and in. 6 points now for Marquand in the ballgame. Lead now to 9. 42 and a half to go here. Cougars have led by as many as 12 in the second half. 12 in the first half, 12 in the second, only trailed by 3 here in the second half. Marquand with one more free throw coming. He'll set, shoot, and score. Timeout taken, I believe, by Kankakee with 42 seconds left to go in this ballgame. The Cougars extend now to 10 points. They lead 80-70. Want to watch the end of this Region 4 matchup? The only place you can watch it is right here on HMC. Stick with us, everyone. Welcome back, everyone. 42 seconds left to go in the ball game. Cougars lead by 10, 80-70. Cougars are in the double bonus, and I believe the Cavaliers are in 1-1, but I can't imagine the Cougars are going to foul them. They're going to let them chew up a little bit of clock here. Nice job by the Cougars. Again, not necessarily looking for the steal here, just slowing them down a little bit. Woods all the way to the rack himself. No good, shot clock is off. D2 will pick up the board, and that probably will end it here. 24 seconds left to go in the ball game. And the Cougar crowd coming alive on a big win by Highland here. Again, they had the upset against Daly, where everything went wrong. A lot of things went right today for the Cougars, and they're gonna pull this one out. Your final score, the Cougars with a big win today, 80-70. Troy Cole adds a little exclamation point to that. Coach not too happy. But that is your final score, your Highland Cougars with a big win in the Region 4. And they move to 4-1 on the season. The Cavaliers drop to 5-2. But final score, 80-70. We'll be back here in a little bit with some stats. So stick with us. Another one busts the dust. Another one busts the dust. Ow! Another one busts the dust. Hey, hey! Another one busts the dust. Hey!
Thank you.
Welcome back, everyone. Final score, Highland with the win, 80-70. Scoring goes as follows. Marquand Adams, 7 points, 0 boards. El Bosco Basterachia, 2 points, 1 board before the injury. Tyler Johnson, 8 points, 4 boards. Monem Aboud, 10 points. Boris Parachitza, 6 points. Omar Njaya, 6 points, 1 board. And Cyrus Noel, 8 points, 6 boards. My Cougar of the game, I'm going to go with 2 today. A great job handling the rock and scoring as well. D2, 15 points and 6 boards. And Troy Cole Jr., 18 points, 4 boards for your Cougars. Again, the Cougars avenge the region. We'll check that out here. I've just got words of a triple-double here by D2. Yes, 15 points, 12 assists, and 10 boards for D2. Obviously, my boards were way off. Shows why I'm not a statistician. But a great job by D2 with a triple-double tonight. Again, a big win for the Cougars. It was a good test and a good win for Highland here, and a great job here. We'll be back here shortly with the head coach of the Highland Cougars, Mr. Luke Norman. So stick with us, everyone. We'll be back in a minute.
Another one busts the dust. Another one busts the dust. Ow! Another one busts the dust. Hey, hey! Another one busts the dust. Hey! Swirl it down the street with the people way down low. Ain't no sound but the sound of speed. Machine guns ready to go. Are you ready? Hey, are you ready for this? Are you hanging on the edge of your seat? Out of the doorway, the bullets rip to the sound of the beat. Yeah. Another one bites the dust. Another one bites the dust. And another one gone. And another one gone. Another one bites the dust. Yeah. I'm gonna get you too. Another one bites the dust. How do you think I'm gonna get along without you when you're gone? You took me for everything that I had and kicked me out of my own. Are you happy? Are you satisfied? How long can you stand the heat? Out of the doorway, the bullets can reach us.
Oh,
I'm not in charge. I don't care. I just work here. Welcome back. We are now being joined with head coach Luke Norman. Good test today.
Obviously, everything fell apart on Thursday, but a good way to get back in with a really good team. How do you think you guys did tonight?
I'm super proud of him, man. I mean, as you guys saw, Gonzalo went down early. Marquand was banged up from last game. Ravine's out for some issues. Matt's out for some issues. Some guys played a lot of minutes for us. And guys just stepped up, and it was a complete team win. I thought Mo came in and gave us a lot of energy, hitting shots, and then Demetrius, D2, playing 37 minutes and getting a triple-double. That's big time.
Great job by the players. Again, you're down some players. The players had to step up. You had 13 turnovers in the first half, only two in the second half. What changed?
We just took care of the ball, man. It wasn't anything I did. I just went in there and said, make smart plays, simple plays. And I thought in the first half, we had a chance to really extend the lead. We were up 10, and we turned it over about four times. So I thought we took care of the ball. Finally got some stops in the second half. And again, I'm just proud of them. That's a really big win with a lot of guys playing minutes. And just we always have that next man up mentality.
Had shot 49% and 74% from beyond the arc. Offensively, probably one of the better games you guys have had lately.
Yes, definitely. I mean, Thursday, we were so bad, but that's over with. And we came out here and responded. That's what it's about, is responding after a loss like that. Some teams go their separate ways, some teams come together, and I thought we came together pretty well.
Gonzalo out a little bit, or?
We'll see, man.
Went out of doctor, but.
Yeah, we'll see. I know his ankle's pretty beat up, so. Now we got tomorrow off, and then we got a big week next week, so.
All right, good win. Congratulations.
Appreciate you guys.
Coach Luke Norman of the Highland Cougars. They moved to 4-1 on the season. Again, 2-1 in the Region 4. That's important. That's seeding for the end of the tournament, which, again, I believe is here. Again, D2, 15 points, 10 boards, and 12 assists. Triple-double for the sophomore from St. Paul, Minnesota. Again, next broadcast will be this upcoming Tuesday, November the 21st. The ladies will take on Milwaukee Tech tonight, or this afternoon there in La Crosse. But they will be back home on Tuesday. So a great answer to their upset loss to Daly. The Cougars knock off Kankakee 80-70. And they got a big week coming up against Moberly. I think it's next week. But either way, they've got some big games coming up. So for the Salt and the Sound, Jim Yeager, this is a marvelous one. Mark Masters. Good night, everyone. Cougars win by 10. We will see you this upcoming Tuesday.